Okay guys, we got this device, MacBook Pro Retina 13-inch E1502. Customer complained, no power. Not charging. Now after taking all the screw back side, I will check what's inside, because the device has no power. Oops. The customer said it suddenly died, and he did not spill any liquid or drop it, but I think he's lying. First, we will remove the motherboard so that we can check all the parts that was hit by liquid. We will be focusing on the liquid spot or the liquid damage parts. This is gonna be hard to fix, but we will try. First thing we can do is we will be focusing on where the most liquid damaged parts we will be doing cleaning and checking if there's any loose contact or burn parts. Guys, this is a sticky liquid damage. What I mean is, it is more likely a soda or a tea with sugar. So what we're going to do is we will clean this with this. This is more likely a lacquer thinner, so what it can do is to dissolve the sugar and hopefully we can remove it easily. Guys, don't do this on a flex cable or plastic because it will damage it. guys, some of the sugar become solid, like solid as glue. So I need to reheat it so that it will melt. It smells candy. So far, guys, we did not find any damaged parts. It's like, I did not find any burnt parts. So, what I'm doing right now is just purely cleaning. I did not replace anything. Yet. Guys, this is what it looked like. What I'm doing is just remove this solidified sugar. So far, I did not replace any parts yet. I'm just cleaning it up, and this is what the all the parts are look like. It is very small, so I cannot show you directly, but this is what it look like on my microscope. So I hope you have an idea what I'm doing. I'm just removing the solidified sugar and clean it up. Guys, this is just a purely cleaning process. Anyone can do this, and it is much better if right after the liquid spill, just open it and clean it. It is much better and it is very easy. Unlike this, what happened now is like maybe this customer use his laptop for 3 months before it died, and he knew it that it was liquid damage. So it is more difficult if you will wait until it will die. So I hope you got an idea, and I wish I give you some ideas, and you can save your laptop by your own. Now we are checking all the connectors, like the LCD connector, backlit keyboard, backlit connector, everything, all connectors. We also have to clean. Guys, when I see cleaning the connectors, this is what it looks like, for example. So you have to clean this up, then after you can connect to the board. Guys, this is the trackpad connector, and we have to clean it also, as you can see. Guys, this is an example of a connector which is you have to clean it, because if you will not clean, it will have a loose connection and it will be not functioning or functioning abnormally. See, this is the Wi-Fi card, and I'll show you the battery. This is the keyboard, and this is the battery. This is what it looks like if the parts was damaged by liquid. I'm sure it was burned, and maybe some short circuit. Now guys, after cleaning everything, it is not perfectly clean, but this time we will be diagnosing what's really the problem. We will put it back together, and we will see what will happen. Thank you. So now guys, we will not yet connect the battery. We will just see if the board is working. Now guys, it is working. Hopefully, trackpad and mouse is working too. Yeah, it's working. The keyboard is working. Now we will shut this down, then we will check the battery. I wish the battery is working too, because if not, we will have to replace it. Now I will connect the battery and guys, some of the keys are hard to press, so it means more cleaning, a lot of cleaning. As I've told you, it will not be like this if he directly clean it as early as possible. Guys, as you can see, there is no battery detected. Battery was not detected. So now guys, I will return all the screw for the motherboard, and we will be replacing the battery. For cleaning guys, I am still using this cleaning solvent. This is the new battery we have. It's for the model A1502 MacBook Pro Retina 13 inch. Guys, you need to be very careful when dealing, when removing this battery. Do not, please do not punctured or make it a short circuit. Yes, it will be a big problem. while removing this one, if you see a smoke, you should have a fire extinguisher ready. You know, it is damaged when you see like this. At least you have an idea. Guys, when you buy a battery online, you will notice some not so good fitting in here. So it is normal because I don't know, maybe factory problem. It's just normal. I've encountered it almost all the time. So now guys, we will check if the battery is working properly, or else there's another problem. It's low guys, but it is working. Guys, as you can see, now the battery is showing. So, guys, this is another video me not all the time you need to replace the parts, you know. If you open your laptop, then you check the parts are not worn or maybe only just need cleaning. You have to do it. It's very simple, and also just using this solvent or any solvent, cleaning solvent. Make sure you are using a cleaner that is not it will not make your board short circuit. Do not use any cleaner that is a conductor, like water, water with soap or anything conductor. Just use cleaning solvent, electronic cleaning solvent like this, and also or you can use a lighter fluid, something. Make sure it is not a conductor. And guys, please subscribe to my channel. This time I cannot show you about replacing parts, only the battery, but main parts on the motherboard, this time nothing, because we just only clean that one and it works. So I hope you guys subscribe to my channel. I hope you get some ideas. Take care and God bless.